Seriously, guys, I'm getting underpaid for this.
Hey guys, Janik here for Cinecom.net, and welcome back to Copycat Friday. It's a weekly series where we recreate effects from famous movies and music videos. Wait, let me stop you right there, Janik. Like you can see, we have a dirt on the lens. Again. We clean it every week, but it keeps reappearing. Magic. Well, we accepted it and it's now part of the Cinecom branding. Back to you, Janik. And today we are recreating the rainbow echo trail effect from the music video Say So by Doja Cat. The first thing you will notice is the retro look. The orangey color, a little bit faded, some grain on the shots, and of course the black bands on the side. And this will give you the feeling of the old 4:3 aspect ratio and the VHS look. Well, we won't explain this effect today. We already did this 2 years ago, so if you want to learn how to make this look, go to the description below to find a link for that. Now let's cut right to the chase and start with our rainbow echo trail effect. What do you need? A talent who can dance, with a pretty dress of course. And then two shots, one in front of a green screen and one empty shot of the place you want to stand in. Best you take the empty shot first, this way you can match the lighting between the empty and the green screen shot. After that, place your talent in front of the green screen and let him or her dance. A tip I can give you to get the best result, let them mostly dance with their arms. They can do whatever they want, but out of our own experience, our movements work the best. Look at that, you already have your shots, now let's jump into Premiere Pro. The first thing you can do is place the empty shot on track number 1. Then take the shot of the talent and place that on track number 2. Next up, look for the ultra key effect in the effects library and drag that to your talent's clip. You know the drill, take the color picker, select the green to remove it and fine tune if necessary. Once done, your talent will perfectly stand in your empty shot. Now let's continue with the echo effect. First we have to duplicate the talent clip to the third video track. Then select the clip on track number 2, right click on it and choose nest. In this nested sequence, we are going to create a rainbow trail and afterwards we can easily use the blending modes to blend the nested sequence with the rest. So double click on the nested sequence to open that up. Then look for the echo effect and drag that to your talent clip inside the nested sequence. The settings of the echo effect are pretty straightforward. First set the number of echoes to 8 to get enough repetitions. Then for the perfect spread of these repetitions, set the echo time to -0.055. You let the starting intensity sit on 1, but lower the decay to 0.90. This will make the last ones a little bit more transparent. And the last setting is the echo operator, which you can compare to a sort of blending mode. Set this to composite in front, and this will give you a stacking effect. That was easy! Now let's add some color to it. Create a color mat in the project panel and place it on top of your talent's clip. Next, look for the 4 color gradient effect and drag that to your color mat. Like the name says, you can create a gradient existing out of 4 colors. Choose the colors you want. We are going to go for a yellow, a light blue green color, a pinkish color, and a darker blue. Then if you select the gradient effect in the effects control panel, you can easily position the color points. So place them wherever you want. We are going to put them right where the arm of the talent is. Of course, we only want the colors on our talent. So let's do that now. Duplicate the talent's clip to track number 3. In the effects library, look for the track matte key effect and you can apply that to the color matte. With this effect, we can use the clips above as a matte and creating a sort of mask in the shape of the selected clip. In our case, in the shape of the talent. Set the matte setting to video 3 and boom, you have a perfect mask. Now, of course, we still need to change the blending mode of the color matte to screen. This will make the underlying clip visible, thus showing your talent again, but extra colorful. Now, before I explain the last step, I want to give you a tip for making a fast and easy retro look. Overlays. You can achieve a lot with simple overlays. Just look for the right one, pick the blending mode and bada bim bada boom, you have a retro look. And coincidence or not, but Storyblocks video has a lot of those overlays. From light leaks, to grain, to vintage film strips. With Storyblocks video you can recreate your retro look in no time. And you can download as many videos as you want. This way you can really try out multiple clips to see which one is best. And this all for one fixed price per year. Now, Storyblocks Video isn't only good for overlays, they have so much more. From 4K stock clips, which are perfect for the empty backgrounds you can use in this effect, to easy customizable After Effects templates. Like you can hear, Storyblocks Video is a must-have for every filmmaker. With their low price and unlimited downloads, they are the best tip we can give you. So if you want to start downloading right away, go to the first link in the description below. Okay, now for the last steps. In the nested sequence, select the talents clip on track number 1 and duplicate that to track number 4. Change the blending mode of the duplicate to multiply and lower the opacity to 65. Then remove the echo effect and add the Gaussian blur effect. Here you can set the blurriness to around 14, and that's it. Now go back to your main sequence and select the nested sequence. When holding the Alt key, you can use your arrow keys to nudge the nested sequence one frame to the right. This will give a little offset, so the effect will start after the talent moves. And one last thing, set the blending mode of that nested sequence to hard light. And that will leave you with this super cool effect.
Okay, Jill, you can walk into the shot.
No, Jordi, no.
Jill, walk into the shot and do your dance.
I don't want to. The people are gonna laugh at me.
No, they won't.
Yes, they will.
Yeah, okay, they will. Pretty funny. Anyways, walk into the shot.
No, Jordi, no.
Jill, come on.
We have. No, please, no.
We have to do this, Jill.
No.
Jill, walk and do the shot! We have to do this dance because I want to go home! Thank you, Jill. All right, now do the dance.
As tradition dictates, it's time for Janik's Fun Fact Fountain! Apparently, the song Say So from Doja Cat is quite popular on TikTok, and it's even a dance challenge on the social media platform. How is showing a dance a challenge? I don't get it. You know what's a challenge? Cine Battle. That's a challenge. As you can see, I never use TikTok. Maybe I should? What do you guys think? Is TikTok worth my time? Let me know in the comments below. Oh yeah, by the way, if you search for Jordi Vanderpot on TikTok, you can find Jordi's 1 hour TikTok addiction. It's super silly. But that was it for today, guys. I hope you learned something new. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you Storyblocks Video for the support. And like always, stay creative.
Yeah, music video.
Why don't you say so? Didn't even notice your punches at the roll. You gotta keep the focus. Why don't you say so?
Ha 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 ha!